Thank you for joining this CS board video about MPT-7B, a new open source large language model developed by MosaicML that caught a lot of attention for being eligible for commercial use, unlike other open source LLMs like LLaMA. Speaking of LLaMA, MPT-7B was tested to be comparable in results to LLaMA-7B while defeating other open source LLMs. Another interesting capability is the long context length of 65,000 tokens, which is way larger than other open source models, and also larger than GPT-4. Let's start with some facts about the model. MPT stands for MosaicML Pretrained Transformer. The model architecture is a decoder-only transformer, similar to GPT model. MPT-7B was trained for 9.5 days on MosaicML platform, in the cost of $200,000, which even if it sounds a lot, it is faster and cheaper than what it would take to train a LLaMA-7B model from scratch. It was trained on 1 trillion tokens, like the LLaMA model, and as mentioned before, it is commercially usable, which is unlike LLaMA. MosaicML mentions that the model and training code includes a lot of optimization from the open source community. One example is flash attention, that includes GPU optimization and sparse calculations. Another very cool attribute is the ability to handle super long inputs thanks to ALiBi, which we will expand about in a minute. To show what is possible with the MPT model, Mosaic also released 3 fine-tuned versions of the model. So they started with MPT-7B model 3 times, and each time they fine-tuned the model on different datasets according to the purpose of the fine-tuned model. The first one is called MPT-7B Instruct, which is purposed for short-form instruction following. It was trained on datasets such as Dolly, and is also commercially usable. The second one is called MPT-7B Chat, which is a chatbot-like model for dialogue generation, which was trained on datasets such as Evolve Instruct, which is a very cool dataset which was created using LLM. I explained on this dataset in the video about Wizard LLM if you're interested to learn about it more. Alpaca and few more datasets were also used to fine-tune this model. The downside is that this model is not commercially usable. The third model is called MPT-7B StoryWriter 65K+, and here it gets even more interesting. This model was fine-tuned in order to read and write stories. It was trained on fiction books from the Books3 dataset. It is commercially usable, similar to the base and the instruct model, although here it is debatable, since there are copyrights for the books that was trained on. It was trained with huge context lengths of 65,000 tokens, and they were also able to extrapolate to 84,000 tokens in inference time thanks to ALiBi. So let's talk about what is this ALiBi which MosaicML attribute a lot of the success of the model to. ALiBi is a relative positional method. Let's understand what it means. Given an input sequence such as the squirrel was waiting to get a, we want to train our model to predict the next word in the sentence. A possible one in this case can be a peanut. Let's say each word in this sentence gets to be a token. Then to provide the sentence to the model, each token gets an embedding, which is a vector of numbers that captures the meaning of the word. The transformer model reads the words in parallel, and is unaware of the position of each word in the sentence. In order to sort of force it to be aware to the word position in the input sequence, a common approach is to add absolute positional embeddings. The original method is called sinusoidal position embeddings, which we won't dive into in this video. But important note on this is that these embeddings are fixed and not learned by the model. Another approach is to train positional embeddings, meaning to let the model learn them as part of the training. In both cases and more, ALiBi research paper showed that these methods have a major drawback, which is that they don't extrapolate well to longer sequences, meaning that if in inference time the model encounters a longer sequence than it was trained on, then it gets much less certain about the results. So ALiBi paper suggests to not add these absolute positional embeddings, but rather just provide the model with the word embeddings and add relative information regarding the position of the words as part of the model architecture. The way they do that, in a simplified description, is by a small change in the attention layer of the model. The attention helps the model to pay more or less attention to certain parts in the sequence that will help the model yield a good prediction for the next word. As part of the attention calculation, each word gets sort of an attention score. In our example input sequence, we have 7 words, so A1 to A7 here represent the score for each word. ALiBi idea is to subtract a relative value from that score by a factor of a parameter m, which is a value between 0 to 1. This way the score is reduced more and more for words that are farther away from the end of the sequence. There are usually more than one attention blocks in a model, in order to help the model pay attention to multiple parts of the sequence. Each block is also called an attention head. And for each such block, ALiBi sets a different value for M, for better diversification. Think that if M is large, then farther away attention scores will be impacted much more than if M is small. So this diversification can help. Using ALiBi, MPT Story Writer was able to handle up to 84,000 tokens context, although it was trained with up to 65,000 token context inputs. If you like this content, then please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to help this channel grow. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again in the next video.